Hello, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales. I'm the RPG chick. We got this robot working. We have to give it rat DNA.
Ugh, it looks like the X100 really liked that rubbish. At least it's purring like a cat. Now I just have to get it to hunt like one.
Now, we've explored around here pretty thoroughly. Let's go outside. We need some rat DNA.
That's the exit. But I can't call it a day yet.
Okay.
First, I have to teach the house robot to catch rats. A thieving rat. Deviant.
Where would I get rat DNA?
Hello, Master Brewer, sir.
Aye, aye, Wilbur.
There's an evil slime living in a kitchen.
Did you know there's an evil slime living in a pot in the kitchen?
Oh, yes. It nicked a sausage off me this morning.
That's evil.
Well, doesn't that bother you?
Well, yes. Live and let live, I say. As long as it doesn't develop a taste for beer.
So the slime can live, but the rats must die.
So I'm supposed to uncreate the robot and send it after the rat?
Definitely. Shouldn't be too difficult for you, being a gnome and all.
You've heard this.
I'm not really all that into technology. I'll take care of the robot then, and the rat.
Aye, go on then.
Alright, where would I find some rat DNA? How would I get some rat DNA? There's gotta be something we can do with this coffee pot. Back in the kitchen again. Now that didn't work. Huh. Well, look at the net. Oh, I didn't notice that before.
I know. A very roughly knotted net with loose ends. Maybe it's used for fruit. Although I've never seen any fruit around here, the master brewer prefers heartier fare.
Get it. Now, I figure we use it on the rat, but catch the slime with the net.
I'm not likely to be able to catch the slime with the net. It's
so.
Too slimy.
Too slimy. Before I leave this room, let me see if I can use this on anything else. No.
The net is pretty coarsely woven. The rat would probably slip through. Besides, I don't feel like sticking my hand in the dark hole.
I can't combine anything here. Empty the coffee pot? Oh no, this is the empty coffee pot. What am I supposed to do with the net? Show him the net.
Do you still need this net? Or can I have it?
Just take it. It's got a few holes in it.
Okay, I can't ask him if I can have the coffee pot or not. Well, we can't leave this area. Hold up. I have no idea what I'd be doing with this, but... maybe there's something else in here I haven't noticed.
The rubbish bin is almost overflowing. Presumably it's my job to empty it, but... oh well.
Take the rubbish. Okay, now we got rubbish. Nothing else we can do with this rubbish. Be the robot with rubbish? Could the rat DNA be possibly on here?
The robot is already chock full of disgusting leftovers. It can't hold anymore. Besides, it's already running.
Well, what am I gonna do with that? We got all this crap. You know, and I think about maybe combining something, but that didn't work. Can I read this again?
So the robot is activated. Now, how did that rat hunting bit go again? In order to hunt rats or vermin of any kind, you must first feed the X100 with DNA from your target. DNA carriers include hair, blood, sweat, snot, and other things.
Which should be in the rat hole.
That seems to be the rat hole where the little beast plans its raids. The rat has chewed through the wood. There's some fur hanging from a splinter.
Oh, I just
I'll take that.
Thank you. I just had to look at it again, that's it.
And now the fur, a source of rat DNA.
See.
And it's gone. It won't be back anytime soon either. Problem solved.
All he did was chase the rat. He could have done the same exact thing.
The X100 makes a pretty good rat hunter. I just hope it never mistakes me for a rat.
Sheesh.
Hello, Master Brewer, sir!
Aye, aye, Wilbur.
The rat has made his play.
The rat's gone.
I saw. It's amazing what you little gnomes can puzzle out, eh? The rat's lost his appetite for my hops, at any rate. He won't be coming back for a while.
Can I call it a day now?
Of course you can. Safe home, my lad. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
See you later, lad.
Okay, bye.
I'll leave him alone for now.
All right.
And another day ends. And, as usual, I didn't save any princesses, or fight any dragons, or hunt any orcs. I chased a rat off, and I didn't even do it myself. I used a fully automated robot instead. It's going to take more than that before my statue stands next to Knight Tilo in the Hall of Heroes, but I'm going to make it one day.
The Hall of Heroes. I'd like to see that. Destiny is coming. Okay, so this is how the story comes together.
Hey, you! Boy! You've got to get me out of here! Quickly, please. I was abducted. An elf freed me. They want... You've got to believe me. I have the key to something that could determine the fate of the war. Listen, boy. It's too late. You see this ring?
Take the one ring.
It's the key. Take it to the human arts mage in the town of Seastone. You understand?
But...
All of our fates depend on it.
He wants it. Ring taken.
Oh, dew, nobody's going to believe this.
Dew.
There's no way I'll make it down to the human town by the sea on my own. I need help. I should ask the Master Brewer for help. Or Grandad. He fought for the Alliance.
So where the hell's Ivar? I mean, look at this ring.
A heavy gold ring. Ooh, it feels warm. There is some fine script on the inside, but I can't make out what it says.
It might be in Elvish. We can use the ring on something. Look at the icicle.
Of course, it's pretty cold all year round up here in the mountains. But this year, winter came particularly early.
Let's take the icicle.
It worked. I got one.
Got one! We can't put the icicles in the coffee pot?
It'll take a long time for the icicle to melt. After all, the pot isn't all that warm. I should speed up the melting process.
Okay. Well, we could speed up the melting process by putting it on the stove, but, not sure why we want to do that just yet.
Probably the statue of some famous dwarven leader. I don't know much about their history.
Look at a stretched out tarpaulin. Tarp.
The tarps are supposed to offer the stonemasons a little protection. They have to be pretty tough if they're out there in all kinds of weather.
Oh, we can take it right off the scaffold, okay.
I'm not climbing up there, it's all iced up. I'd probably end up breaking my neck.
Okay, maybe we're not doing that.
The bastion looks so impressive. However, many of the halls and corridors were never completed. Originally, hundreds of dwarves were supposed to live here to defend the Mountain Kingdom's northern front. Now the Master Brewer and my family are the only ones left.
Okay, so this is kind of like searching around to see, you know, what can be looked at. Look at the entrance to the gnome hole.
That's the entrance to my family's gnome hole. We've been living here for generations.
I'm just making sure.
There's no way I can walk all the way to Seastone. That's many days' march through these mountains.
And look at the bridge. Yeah, he's not crossing that. Just making sure there's nothing that we're not going to scroll. come about this way. Run! No, he won't go farther than that. Okay, let's go in the gnome hole. See what's going on at home. I'm home! Large metal gate.
That door is part of Dad's living space optimization unit. Behind it is sort of a car park for rooms.
Living space optimization unit. So these gnomes are obviously tinkerers, as we know them from other such fantasy environments. A chair.
A chair. This chair is completely uninteresting. Like I said, a chair to sit on.
But I like looking at it.
It's still a chair.
Yeah.
A totally uninteresting chair, which is absolutely no help to me. Not now, not ever.
Take the chair.
It is a chair. Honest.
But just look at it. We just look at it. Just look at it.
Okay, whatever. It's a horse.
Will you look at it?
A beautiful big white horse.
My God, just look at it.
What is your problem? A chair is a chair is a chair.
Wait. You said it was a horse. Liar.
I'm not going to answer.
Yeah, because you'd be full of lies if you did.
The chair, of course. That's the key to it all. Not a chair. This chair is completely uninteresting.
Okay, we're just recycling here. Picture.
That's my family.
Oh, here we go.
Right now, just Granddad and I are holding down the fort. The others are all at a technology trade show down south. My dad is a mechanic and a physicist. He primarily works on, things.
Things.
Mother is just a hall wife and geneticist.
A hall wife.
The baby is my little sister, Sydney. I think she'll be a researcher, too. She once doubled her baby phone's data transfer rate using nothing but a rattle and a rubber ball.
She looks pissed.
My other little sister is Maggie, my parents' pride and joy. She mainly concentrates on robotics, combat robots to be exact. Granddad is a war veteran and conducts secret military research, whenever Dad lets him in the workshop, that is. Looks like I'm the proverbial exception to the rule. I'd rather go out into the world and become a mage, a hero like Nightilo. But someone has to look after Granddad and the Master Brewer. I'm more of a local, unsung hero.
All right. Oh, we can go down. We can leave. Let's look at the levers here.
Those are the controls for our living space optimization unit. My father invented them.
All right, before we leave here, let's look at everything. Number one rule, look at everything.
A flower pot full of potting soil. Hmm, doesn't look like Mother planted anything in there.
Adventure games. Look at everything. Take everything that isn't tied down. And if it is tied down, find out a way to untie it, then take it. Plants.
Those are my mum's plants. She grows a lot of that green stuff. She keeps trying to genetically change the plants so they can grow up here amidst the icy mountains.
We got some kind of chemistry experiment here.
My mother is a real hall wife. She spends her time on chemistry, biology, genetics, and that kind of stuff.
Oh, yeah. Human beings completely do the same thing. The apparatus on the wall.
One of my dad's inventions. He calls it a time measurometer. It splits the day into two periods of 12 hours each and shows which hour we are currently in.
Huh. I think it should be time measurometer. Measurometer.
Sometimes I think that thing uses time up instead of just showing it.
We can't look at it anymore. I wonder if we have repeated dialogues for everything.
I think I'll just leave that alone. We gnomes have a golden rule, hands off another gnome's experiments.
So we can keep looking at things and he'll say something else.
The plants have grown. I could have sworn they weren't here yesterday. Mum probably uses a really good fertilizer. Doesn't look like Mother planted anything in there. Doesn't look like Mother planted anything in there.
Okay, some things will repeat. Huge cogs. Okay, I didn't see those.
Those cogs belong to Dad's living space optimization unit. The machine takes up a total of 3 rooms in our hall.
Is it really optimized then, if it takes up that many rooms? Alright. Use the bedroom. Let's use the kitchen lever.
Our kitchen.
Grain mill.
Our flour mill. Mother makes sure we eat a healthy diet. One day we'll all be big and strong, comparatively. There's still some grain in the funnel. Barley, I think.
See that? Now we learn that it's good to look at things over and over again. Kitchen cupboard. There's a vial.
A pale blue glowing liquid. Something tells me it's probably not good for you.
A vial. Who would have thought?
My mum wrote super fertilizer on it. Probably one of her genetic experiments.
We're gonna use it on the plants. Use it on the plants. Or in the flower pot.
Why should I fertilize potting soil when there's nothing planted in it?
Because it just hasn't grown yet. You've got to use the super fertilizer.
Why should I fertilize pot...
I was so excited, too. The blue bottle. A blue bottle?
Master Merlin's antibacterial kitchen cleaner. The dirt disappears like magic. If only I could cast spells like Merlin, or any other household cleaner for that matter.
Take the blue bottle. Well, we're getting quite a vast array of stuff here. Just checking, make sure you can't combine anything with anything. Knife block.
Mum hid the knives as a precaution after Grandad's knife throwing training classes last year. She doesn't trust us anymore.
Take the scissors out of the knife block. Now we got scissors. I love this game. This is freaking awesome. Is that it? Are you in the way of something I can look at? I guess that's it. Just making sure, a little pixel hunting going on, okay. No, this will just close it, right? I just want to see. The gnome room. Is that like the living room?
This is my very cool room.
Rucksack. Oh, we can carry more
items. My old gnome scout rucksack. Pretty tough, that. But somehow I always had the feeling it could have been a little larger.
Well, let's take it.
I wonder if putting small bags and pouches in it would increase the rucksack's capacity.
I don't know, but... Can I put something in the rucksack? No, I guess not. I figured the rucksack would maybe increase the amount of items I can have in my inventory, but maybe there is no limit. Oh, yeah, a tennis racket here?
My old tennis racket, although I was never very good.
Take it.
The catgut is missing. What did I use that for?
Catgut? Not the net to the frame of the tennis racket. Now, you wouldn't be able to do this if there wasn't a reason for doing it. That's my logic.
I'll just knot the loose ends around the frame. Done. Wouldn't want to play tennis with it, but it does make a fine scoop net.
A scoop net. Now we got a homemade net. Nice. What else we got around here? Anything? Here's some books or something? That's it. Nothing much interesting in our room here. The bedroom lever. Let's check out Maggie's later.
That's the lever for my parents' bedroom. I can't use it until they get back.
Alright. Maggie's?
That's the lever for my little sister's bedroom. I'm not touching that. Well, she builds combat robots, and she kind of hinted that she knows how to protect her privacy.
Huh. That, my friend, is just another puzzle to overcome. So, that's it. So we're going down now.
And down we go.
Cool.
Halt! Who's there?
Hi, Grandad. It's me.
I doubt it. What's the password?
Rumpelstiltskin. What kind of a password?
Password? I don't know anything about a password.
Bad answer. Prepare to die, scoundrel.
It's important, Grandad.
So is the password. We are at war, damn it. War suffereth no carelessness. So, the password.
Decisions, man. Fluffy Bunny!
Was it Fluffy Bunny?
You wish. Die, maggot!
It's important, Grandad.
So is the password. We are at war, damn it. So?
It's nuclear first strike.
Nuclear first strike, sir.
Correct. What do you want?
A gremlin gave me this ring. He said it's very important. He said the ring has to be delivered to the Archmage as quickly as possible.
A ring? Have you checked it for contamination?
What?
For curses, hexes, poison.
No.
What am I talking about? Of course you have. No one would accept a ring from a gremlin and not check it for curses.
Right.
Dangerous little blighters, those gremlins. You shouldn't feed them after midnight, you know.
That's another kind.
The gremlin said this ring could decide the course of the entire war.
Decide the course of the war? That would be... Where is this gremlin?
He's been kidnapped. He barely had time to give me this ring. It should be taken to the Archmage as quickly as possible.
The Archmage? Yes. He'd know what to do.
Sure.
This is what we've been waiting for. This is what we've trained for!
We trained?
This is the hour in which a stout youngster becomes an adult. The hour of glory. The hour of fame. Hour!
But what do you mean stout?
Does everyone know what they have to do?
No.
Right, men. Let it be so.
Oh, that's his leg. He's got a metal leg. I'm like, what kind of floor is this? But it's his leg making that sound. Okay, he's having trouble with something. Let me... I'm just watching you. Okay. Let me tune off for this time. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. Having a blast so far. And, yeah. See you then. Bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.